Well, my friends, canning season is upon us. So I have cut some herbs and I definitely have a lot of green beans. That's basil. I got all kinds of stuff that has come out of the garden. There's been a couple of things I didn't quite have, especially my corn. And I had to get it from my local farmer. But, and I'm not even ashamed to say that, they have the most phenomenal corn. But anyway, I have a lot of stuff going on. So it's time to preserve this bounty. So today we are going to can up some green beans. And then we are going to make a hearty vegetable soup that we will be canning up and getting that all ready for winter time. So stay along with me and help me get this done together. Now, because I have so much to do today, I've decided I'm gonna use my Oster turkey roaster, because roasters work great for canning. And if you don't have a roaster, highly recommend you get one. They just make life easy. They're great for salsa, tomatoes, making soups, pretty much anything, really. So I've got that out back there. And I'm just gonna start getting the stuff ready that I'm gonna throw in there first to try to give me a little more counter space so I have some working room to proceed forward. And then what I need to do is all of my beans that I have here, the ends need to be snapped off. You can cut them, break them, whatever. And then I'll probably put them at least in half, if not thirds. So they're more bite-sized, like they would be if you were to buy them in the store. And then all my scraps are most likely gonna be going to my chickens. Anything that, I don't know. I think it's all gonna actually go to my chickens. They love it. The more scraps I give them, it seems to be the better my eggs are. So I will probably give it to them. But if there is something left over that I'm not gonna give them, I'll put it in my compost bin. So you should never have to really worry about throwing things away. These are all really great things that you can use to help get your garden going for next year. So if I give it to the chickens, they give me my eggs, then they give me my manure. I have their eggshells that I use, their manure, which breaks down, and so on and so on and so on. So anyway, I'm gonna get started getting everything done. Now, I probably should mention that I am putting potatoes, probably a couple different kinds of squashes, kohlrabi, corn, yes, some beans, garlic, peppers, onions, carrots, kale, celery, some herbs. I don't remember if I mentioned green peppers or not, and kohlrabi. So all that stuff is gonna get mixed in, and then I'll probably put a few of the herbs that I picked today. To be honest with you, everything I do, I just am rough chopping. I don't like wasting my time. And you can mix and match and put whatever you've got on hand. You know, there is no rhyme or reason that you need to have something exact. It's what you grow or what you can get your hands on to put away for you and your family. So just because I'm doing something, don't feel like you have to do it. And then really, I rough chop everything because as the soup cooks down, I'm just gonna emulsify it, and then I don't have to worry about even chunks or did something cook properly. I am just simply going to make it a creamy soup, and that way some of the flavors, like my rutabagas, I think sometimes that almost radishy could be overwhelming if it's in a bite-sized form, but when it's blended in with all these other flavors, it's not so bad and it actually tastes quite nice.
So I'm just going to keep on rough chopping and I'll check back in a few minutes. I had to jump back on real quick. I don't know if you've used one of these tools before, but it is one of my all-time favoriteest things to use during canning season. And this is for corn. And to be quite honest with you, like, it's sturdy. I just love it. It makes life so easy. I can't even tell you, but I'll show you. You simply just place it and go down. And it just takes the corn right off. And with the little backstop thing, I mean, it just goes to the perfect level. It's the greatest invention ever. I don't know about that, but it saves so much time. And I use it every year, and I will try to remember my best to put a link down in the, I'm sure it's on Amazon and my Amazon affiliates in the description, and that way you can see what I'm talking about. If you can get your hands on one of these, it will save you so much time. Okay, thanks. One thing I forgot to mention, and hopefully you're all doing it, but as you go through your vegetables, anything that has seeds, save your seeds. As long as you have good quality seeds, you've got harvest for next year. And honestly, that's something that's very important. Now, I also wanted to point out, if you have a bad piece like this is here, don't put that in with your canning. That can taint the whole thing. I will, however, feed it to my chickens. So, but yeah, save your seeds. It's a great way to get you one step further for the following year. So randomly, I remember that I had this old ham hock in my freezer. It's a little frostbite, but that's okay. I would prefer to have put this maybe in my crock pot overnight and get the broth from the bone and the little chunks of meat. But since that didn't happen, I'm not going to stress on it too much. I'm just going to throw it in the roaster with everything else. And if anything, I'll have a little bit of pieces and some great flavor. No puppies. No! Okay. I think I've got this about as filled as I really care to have it. I've added, don't know how many cups, but I added basically a bowl full of good filtered water. I'm gonna add some salt and pepper. I've got rosemary and thyme in here, and I'm just going to kind of keep an eye on it, stir it every now and again so everything's mixing up well. And it looks like I'm going to be turning this up to about 300, and I'll put the lid on it, and then we'll check back in on this after a little while. In the meantime, I'm just going to continue to get my green beans trimmed up and cut up so I can get those pressure canned. And if I end up having not enough to completely fit in a jar, I may just throw a few more into the mix here. But so far, we've got this roaster pretty dang full, and we'll just keep going from there. Okay, so
I have my first 7 jars ready to go. I've decided to go ahead and do a raw pack versus a hot pack, just because I've got too many other things going on with making that soup. So because I am using quart jars instead of pint jars, it is 1 teaspoon of salt. If I was doing the pints, it would be a 1/2 teaspoon, and then I'm simply going to fill these up with boiling water. Now, it should be noted, I do have my couple inches of water in my pressure canner. Oops, actually make it in the hole. I hate it when it does that and then it spills all over. You want a generous 1 inch of head space. More hot water.
If you've got any bubbles, you need to work that around with a fork, a knife, a spoon, something. You don't want the bubbles in there, because then you know it's not gonna be food safe. Now this one is good, but it's going way over my 1 inch guideline. So it's important to back it off, even when you spill and make a mess. The other important tip is to make sure that you wipe all the rims very carefully. Not only are you making sure that there's nothing on your rim so it has a proper seal, but you're also moistening that for your lid. And as an added bonus, it's also a great way when you're got your finger down and you're rubbing it with through the paper towel, you can actually feel, just in case there's any kind of nick in the jar. Rings need to be finger tight, not overly tight. And then you can just place them right into your pressure canner. These are not to be water bath canned. You also do not want a water bath can any soup that you make. Okay. We've got them all in there, and we're gonna bring this up to temperature, so I'm gonna get the lid on. So right now we are just going to let this build up until it starts to vent, which we'll see it come out of here, and I will show you once it gets closer to time for that. And then we are, once we see that, we're going to put our little gadget on and let it build up for 10 minutes and build up our pressure. In the meantime, let's check out our soup. Oh my goodness. It really smells delicious and it's definitely breaking down. Let me give this a good whirl and I'll hold the camera over here. Now I did end up adding quite a bit more water. If I had to make a wild guess, I would say that it was probably somewhere near 12 cups total because this was so full and it needs some liquid, especially for that bone broth. Okay, so as you can see, part of the kale is slowly breaking down. It really smells quite wonderful. I've even noticed that part of my ham bone is breaking apart, which is exactly what I was hoping that it would do. So I'm just going to keep letting everything cook down. Let's see. It's almost been 2 hours at this point. I'm guessing maybe another 2 or 3 hours, and then we'll probably be good to go, but we'll see. Okay, so it is now venting, and I don't think it shows up with my light in here, but I don't know how to make it show up, but I promise you there is a lot of steam coming out of that right this particular moment. Did that catch it? I just can't seem to make it show up in here. So once that does that, you need to set your timer for 10 minutes and then you're going to put on your weighted dial and build up pressure. So right now I'm going to set my timer. So now I've got my weight on because my 10 minutes is up. I need to build pressure. I'm going to build it up to 10 pounds of pressure. And my stove is on 8. I'm going to go ahead and start turning it down a little bit, just because I know that with my glass top, it's going to go wonky. So I'm gonna get this up to 10 pounds of pressure. You do need to watch it and maintain it. You don't really want it going too far one way or another. And then I will set my timer for 25 minutes and go from there. Okay, it looks like I've got this pretty well broken down to where I want it. I still have very few small chunks in here, which is exactly what I wanted. So now I will just get it in my jars. I have my last batch of green beans going. I've been pretty busy. I'll have 17 total quarts when all's said and done. And I'll show you at the end. Okay, hopefully my air conditioning is not too loud in this video, but I did end up with 19 quarts of green beans and 9 quarts of vegetable ham soup. I did gift away 3 of the quarts of green beans to some families that needed it. But other than that, we have an excellent bounty that we were able to can up from all of those delicious vegetables. And I am so excited
this winter to be eating one heck of a healthy, hearty soup. Anyway, guys, please share with me down below anything that you've canned up recently. I'm so excited to hear what you're doing too. Thanks for watching.